I thought I'd come on and make a quick video while I've still got some followers because they're dropping by the bucket load today. Plant-based posse on the way out. Right, okay, so let me just clarify something first. I have a very sarcastic delivery, very acerbic delivery. I always have had. So if the way I deliver my content triggers you, if you feel that you're being judged, I don't judge anybody. If you feel you're being judged, leave. You're not a tree. You can move. Secondly, I don't, when I post something that I know is very triggering, I don't venture into the comment section. So if you're trying to get into a debate with me or trying to get me to answer something, don't do it in the comment section. I won't go in there if I know it's a very controversial post. My energy is I refuse to give it to that space. I just won't do it. There are levels that you can access me at. I have a mailing list, and if you're on there, you're always welcome to email me with anything to discuss anything that I've shared. Obviously, likewise, my Patreon followers and my clients have constant access to me. But random internet people that want to project their unhealed nonsense into my comment section, ah, mate, my energy is not getting spent there. So I'm aware that my comment sections are quite lit, as the kids would say at the moment, because I'm getting inundated with screenshots. So I'd like to come on and just share my thoughts on veganism. Won't be going into the comment section on this video either. Like I said, go via my website if you'd like to contact me. So I'd like to share my thoughts on the veganism movement for two reasons. The stars appear to, that's a fly buzzing around me. The stars appear to have aligned in that my experience with veganism began when I went to live on a commune that I'm going to refer to as a cult, because it was a cult, not because it was a plant-based commune, but because it was run by a sociopath, which was why it was a cult. But some things transpired from there recently about the health of a child that I really don't agree with, and I think is a direct result of the child being malnourished because it's on a plant-based diet. And I've also come across the story of an incredible woman called Katia on Instagram, and Katia was raising her children in the Caribbean. She was on an Ayurvedic yogic diet, you know, no processed shit, all clean, healthy, whole foods. And her son now has a mouthful of metal because he is wearing metal caps. And that's a really common story, is degenerative issues with children that have been raised on a plant-based diet. Weston A. Price has written and done extensive studies on this. And it's one of the reasons that we're seeing such weak kids and weak people. And I really, yeah, following the studies and the teachers that I am now learning from, I am now of the mindset that animal products are necessary for childbearing women and children, especially. And my personal sort of journey with meat began in 2017, when I was pregnant with my youngest daughter, and every single man-made toxin was making me sick. The smell of cigarettes, alcohol, fried food, cleaning products, cosmetics, diesel, petrol, fucking everything. And meat had started to make me vomit. Everything was making me vomit. I was really struggling with meat. And what happened during that pregnancy, that I was unaware of what was happening, but I was becoming very, very, very tuned into source. At the time, I thought I was having a nervous breakdown. And what started to come through for me was when I was throwing up, and it was meat that I had eaten, I was feeling the fear of the slaughtered animal move through me. But I was trying to persist in eating meat because. And where my inner conflict first arose when I started to cut out animal products was that I knew that bone broth was one of the most healing elixirs on earth. The reason that I knew that was because when my son was 10, I realized that he had been damaged by having loads of these and by me making some very uninformed decisions, up to and including, you know, a C-section birth, not co-sleeping with him, putting him into the school system, administering Calpol and Nurofen for any time he had a temperature, antibiotics for any time he had a fucking rash or a sore throat. the list went on. And he was 10 when I came to the realisation I'd fucked up. And I did several detox healing protocols on him, one of them being the GAPS diet, which centres heavily around rebuilding the gut. And bone broth is one of the most healing... Well, it was a healing elixir. I watched it heal my son. So I was having this real inner conflict when meat started making me sick of shit. You know how nourishing meat, like bones can be, and animal products can be, but fuck, it's making you sick. So I cut meat out because I couldn't stomach it, and I couldn't stomach, not only could I not stomach it, I couldn't prepare it, I couldn't cook it. So the family were going without meat as well. But we weren't vegan. We were still drinking raw milk. We were still eating lots of fish and eggs. So we definitely weren't vegan. My vegan experience began in 2020. So for those who know my story, at the start of lockdown, the first lockdown, I took my two youngest daughters and I fucked off when it was essential travel only, because it was essential for my mental health that I got the fuck away from Boris Johnson and Matt Hancock. And I went to Crete and it was amazing. I met Soul Family there. Lisa, if you're watching, I love you. And you know, we had the best time. We bounced around Crete. We were just utter beach bums, utter nomads, and it was incredible. But it was really early on in the, pandemic, and I was apprehensive. I was scared. I was a single mum with two young children, and I got invited to come and stay on a commune by a guy who was on YouTube as a truther, I think you'd call him. And I was like, fuck it, let's go. You know, this could be brilliant. There's other families, there's kids, everyone's free, no one's wearing masks, it's all amazing, absolutely gonna go. And there were two rules. One was strictly plant-based, the other was no alcohol. And I felt I could really get on board with that. Alcohol, I detest, I think it's devil juice. I cannot abide the frequency of anybody, even if they've had one sip. I won't have it around my children, I won't have it around me. If you're gonna have a drink, you wanna get 20 fucking feet away from me, mate. So I was really excited, and I was also at this point, diet was like the last thing on my mind. Honestly, hand on heart, I think I was so, no matter how sovereign we deem ourselves, no matter how, you know, how much we want to be taking radical responsibility, we are programmed to follow the herd. We are programmed to want to run with the crowd. It's part of our makeup. It's what I help you deprogram as a self-sabotage coach, but we run with the herd. And I wanted a herd. So I went to find a vegan herd. Didn't go to find a vegan herd. I went to find a herd, but vegan one was the one that took me. And although I'd started off sort of not eating meat as sort of this conscious decision during pregnancy because of the fear, I soon got really swept up in this whole sense of, you know, yeah, we're doing something. We're sacrificing. We're doing something really. We're saving the world by not eating animals, by not harming any animals. We're saving the world. And, you know, there becomes this, what I've come to sort of really realise when I've taken a step back from this, and it's something I wrote about in one of my recent posts from yesterday, was that there's this level of consciousness that seems to be adapted to the animals, depending on how pet-like they are. And, you know, oh, cows and pigs and sheep, you know, therefore we need to save them. But there's not so much about the insects. Now, there's no doubt people now jump in the car. No, I'm a vegan and I always catch spiders, and I'm a vegan and I never squat mosquitoes. Now you're missing the point, guys. You're missing the point about what is keeping your plant-based diet, what is keeping you in an abundance of plant-based foods is monocropping. So you're literally responsible for the death of earth, the death of soil, when you are funding and, you know, supply and demanding this monocropping. Now, that point never hit me, but you were literally destroying the earth. Now, this isn't, I'm not interested in how you want to raise your children or how you want to eat. I don't care if you get these. I don't care if you eat meat or if you eat fucking nothing but kale for the rest of your days. Genuinely, I don't. But what we all need to be doing is taking radical responsibility. If you want to be plant-based, grow your own. And likewise, if you want to consume animal products, slaughter your own. Because this is where the shift came for me. I couldn't get on board with the fear. I'm not going to eat anything that's being mass produced and packaged in plastic. I don't give a fuck if it's quinoa, almonds, kale, beef, turkey. I'm not eating it. If you've mass produced it and you've packaged it in plastic, I don't want it. Now, No, but obviously when you do start, if you are in the plant-based world and you're following certain accounts, you know, you start getting bombarded with this fear of horrendous abattoirs and animals getting mass slaughtered. Nobody wants to see that. Of course they don't. I've been witness to animal slaughter recently. We now do it at home. It's the most spiritual experience I've ever seen. Every creature on earth has the right to a fearless death. Death is part of life. You're born terminal. We're all gonna die. Nobody, no animal, creature, man, you know, no man, no beast deserves to be terrified. Nobody deserves to be terrified. But one of my most incredible mentors, a woman called Tara, written about her extensively. That woman has changed the trajectory of my life. She was the one who first opened my eyes to humane slaughter. And it's entirely possible you take an animal that is on the land it's been born on, the land that it's spent its life on, it's grazed on. You take it on, it's not put it nose deep in a bucket of its favourite food and put a stun gun to its brain. It knows nothing. One moment it is grazing, the next moment it is at one with the infinite consciousness. And you can taste the difference in the meat. There's no mistaking it. The fear, you can taste the fucking fear in a mass-produced animal and compare it to a humanely slaughtered one. Now you want to talk to me about spirituality. Every single animal has a purpose. Why do you think a cow has four stomachs? Why do you think it has the ability to turn grass into bioavailable nutrients for mankind? Like everything has got a purpose. That cow can regenerate the field with its shit, with its saliva. You're feeding life with every single moment. That cow is never going to be able to change the world, though. You can, though. You are a human being, which is the most powerful thing to have come back to Earth as. You're in a body that can self-heal. You've been given an imagination because you are capable of manifesting and creating anything you want. So you take a healthy cow and nourish a human body with it. That cow goes on to change the world. This is spirituality. I felt closer to God slitting a pig's throat than I ever did sat at that fucking cult in a meditation tent surrounded by a load of fucking turban-wearing vegans telling me that I needed to do Vipassana and stay silent for 24 hours and just sit with it and detach from everything. You just need to detach. You just need to detach. Fuck detaching. I want to get my hands dirty. I want to experience life. Humane slaughter is entirely possible. If you don't want to eat meat, don't eat meat. If you want to stay vegan, stay vegan. But can we all collectively agree that for the sake of the planet, for the sake of taking radical responsibility, the thing you need to be doing is growing your own. Now, if you can thrive on nothing but local and seasonal plant-based foods, dude, hats off to you. You're clearly made of something stronger than I am. For the rest of you, buy your chickens, buy your goats, buy a homestead. Take part ownership of a cow. Go and find your local raw dairy farmer. Go and find your local farmer. Make friends with him. Support him. But stop buying packaged plastic shit. That needs to be the ultimate lesson for everybody. We're killing the planet, all right? We're killing the planet. With your monocropping of your almonds, with your burgers that have been mass slaughtered in fear-induced factories, we're killing the planet. We're killing humanity. We're killing off fucking, you know, life and love. So, apologies if anyone's triggered, but you take offense, I don't give it to you. Now, what I also have come on to talk about is the confessions. So, Katia, who I mentioned earlier, the incredible ex-vegan, has pulled together 50 of, I will say this hand on heart, 50 of the most magical, magnificent healers that we have got earthside right now. Two of my personal mentors, Sufi Chen, who has made me a better mother, a better woman, just a manifesting magnet. Tara, who first opened my eyes to regenerative farming and to, again, just how to be a brilliant mother, a brilliant wife, a brilliant friend, a brilliant sister, a brilliant fucking human. Like I could cry when I think of Tara. That woman has, oh, she's changed my life. This isn't a bundle about veganism versus ancestral eating. This is a bundle about life, about connection, about nourishment, about sustenance. And what excites me about it more than anything is I am trying to share links to this confessions at the moment. I'm all over it on Instagram, and the women that I'm trying to tag can't tag them. Freya Kellett, for example, the most badass but fucking free birth keeper you could ever wish to meet, ex-vegan. Can't even tag the girl. Now, I've been sucked into the fucking metaverse. You know, I was really guilty of it about 12 months ago, like getting all my advice, all my spiritual advice from blue ticks and, you know, people that were in Costa Rica with goddess retreats. Dude, guys, it's bullshit. It's bullshit. If someone's granted influencer status by fucking Zuckerberg, rest assured you don't want influencing by him. These women, these healers, these fucking medicine people that have been pulled together by Katya, shadow banned to fuck, just censored to fuck. You want this information, okay? I'd hazard a guess that pretty much any question I'm getting thrown in my DMs, from how to live freely, how to manifest, how to be a conscious parent, how to nourish your family, is going to be answered within those confessions. I can pretty much hand on heart say that. So download them. They're only available until Sunday, and then the price soars. The price is worth it to just get access to the wisdom of Sufi and Torah alone. Like, I promise you, Sufi Chen could put any online offering out between now and the end of time, and I don't care how fucking much it is, I'd do it. She was offering a weekend retreat in Florida recently, and I genuinely considered forging some tests and getting my ass, that's how, like, I'm flying over to Florida for a weekend. Obviously, later realised that was ridiculous. But that is, like, I would move mountains to work with that woman. Some healers are just here to do God's work. Sufi and Tara, two of them. So won't be going into the comments of this video. I can't remember if I've already said that, but just a little pre-warning. As always, guys, stay safe, stay alert. And even if you are somebody that I trigger the fuck out of, I want you to know that I love you, because we're all one. We're all one. That's the point I'm trying to make with this separation of... I was going to end that then, but I'm not going to keep going. That's the point I'm trying to make with this separation of, like, we're above death. But you're not. We're not above death, because we're killing all the things in the soil. So we've got to take radical responsibility for all of it. I was going to mention something else. I'm going off on a complete tangent. I'm just going to say I love you all. Stay alert. Peace. Download the confessions. You won't regret it. In fact, I'll tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to put the link to download the confessions above this video. Below in the comments, I'm going to put a link to their free masterclass. If you don't want to download the confessions, download that free masterclass, because it teaches you everything you need to know about nourishing your children. And nourish children, nourish little light workers are going to change this world. So, my love goes with you. Stay alert.